The press pull command is perhaps the most misunderstood command in Fusion 360. Let's take a look at what it actually does. We have a simple sketch here. Go to Modify, press Pull. Select the profile. The command window immediately transitions to an extrude. This extrude command is no different from a regular extrude command. Let's extrude this to 50 mm. An extrude step appears in a timeline. So the press pull command basically creates a regular extrude when used on a closed profile. The press pull command is often demonstrated as a means of pressing and pulling on faces. Let's begin the press pull command and select the top face. The command window transitions to an offset face command. This offset face command works in the same way as a regular offset face command. The only difference being that you are able to choose an offset type here. The default offset type is set to automatic. You can see that the distance field has already been populated by the existing extrude distance. So if we change the value here, we are actually changing the value of the existing extrude. Under offset type, there is also a modify existing feature option, which does the same thing. In this case, when we set to automatic, Fusion assumes that we want to modify the existing extrude distance. Let's change this to 70 mm and confirm. Take note that no extra step has been added to the timeline. If we open up the existing extrude, we can confirm that the extrude distance has indeed been changed. Let's repeat the press pull command on the top face. This time round, let's set the offset type to new offset. The distance field resets to 0. Any value that you put into here adds thickness to the existing face. If we put in a value of 10 for instance, the total height becomes 80. In this case, an offset face step has been added to the timeline. A press pull can also be performed on a non-planar face. Let's perform a press pull on the cylindrical face. In this case, take note that the circle sketch is undefined. If we set the offset type to automatic or modify an existing feature, changing the value here would actually change the circle sketch diameter. If the circle sketch had been previously defined, we would only be able to add a new offset. Let's begin the press pull command again. Besides closed sketch profiles and existing faces, we can also select an edge. If we do that, the command transitions to a fillet. This fillet command is no different from the regular fillet command. I want to emphasize that everything we have done so far can be achieved by using the extrude, offset face, and fillet commands without the use of the press pull command. At this point, it should be clear that the press pull command is not really a command in itself. It is more accurately described as a contextual command. Depending on the type of entity selected, the command will transition into either the extrude, offset face, or fillet commands. This command is perhaps useful during the ideation process when you want to have a quick way of shifting faces to create a certain look without having to work through the timeline. However, when it comes to creating robust engineering models, I would strongly advise against using this command. As part of the learning journey into parametric modeling, It is always important to understand every single feature in the timeline. If you want to change any aspect of the model, we should always try our best to go to the source feature to change that. As it stands, the press full command does not add any value to the extrude, offset face, and fillet commands. Having said that, this is a personal opinion and not meant to be a criticism of users who use the press pull command. If you have found a good way of incorporating the press pull command into your workflow, feel free to leave a comment below.